My name is Ryan Larson. I'm in the Flood Protection and Navigation section here at the Corps of Engineers District in Sacramento, and I am a civil engineer in the section. I deployed to Alabama as part of the assistant team leader cadre of folks. It's a national cadre of about 40 people throughout the entire Corps of Engineers. And I went to Alabama on short notice. We had about 12 hours notice, took a red-eye flight out to Alabama. And when I got there, my role as an assistant team leader is to work with the team leader who's in charge of the disaster for Alabama and basically be a project manager and work out scope, schedule, and budget for all of the missions that the Corps of Engineers conducts within the state of Alabama. The big mission in Alabama was debris removal, and but there are also many other things that we did while we were there. We had a temporary housing mission there. We had an emergency power mission, critical public facilities mission, and infrastructure assessment mission. So those were the big missions that the Corps of Engineers was conducting for FEMA and the state of Alabama. My role in that environment was to coordinate everything that the Corps of Engineers was doing and report up to the state and to FEMA and make sure that they knew what we were doing, where we were doing it, and coordinate the state's requests, the Alabama's requests, and FEMA's requests, and get that information back to our folks in the field as well. So basically two-way communication, a lot of interaction with the state of Alabama and FEMA, and then also getting their desires and their requirements down to our folks out in the field so that we can execute the mission. And then we report it up daily, hourly, how we were doing and the progress we were making. My main contribution as assistant team leader in the state of Alabama is to be able to see from day one all of the devastation, the destruction that the tornadoes caused, and to be able to see that 30 days later at the end of my deployment, see how much debris had been picked up, how many houses had been put on people's properties, how many people had their emergency power back up and running on full-time power, and to see all that progress in that short amount of time. It's really an amazing experience to have all those people together that come in and have a unified mission is to help the citizens of the state of Alabama and get them back on their feet. So.